So kilala mo naman yung mga teams natin, right? Mm-hmm. So para sa'yo, sa tingin mo, sino gusto mo manalo? And why?
G1, of course.
Because?
It's because Mines keeps on winning, so I don't know.
Oh, you have a point. Yeah, you have a point. So maybe, tignan natin kung magiging 1-1-2 score na to, right? Alright, so first of all, thank you kasi pumunta ka dito to join us and cast with me. And if you want to add Erica, hanapin nyo Erica. Hindi ko pwede sabihin ko ano yung Facebook niya. Mga Hokage. Ayun. So back to the ball game right now. 4v4 situation. We are watching recheck but wala siyang mahanap dito. And yun nga, si Zach. Zach attack. Oh wow, Dispenser killed one already. Death goes down and Zach finds so much to kill right here. He sees one doctor killing him right here. Dispenser trying to live. Pero yeah, Neruch and 0-2. 0-2 is the only man left. Richa killed one. Let's see what will happen to 0-2 right here. 42 HP left. Pero mukhang buhay. And Dispenser finished there. The score now is 2-0. Sobrang ganda na pinakita ng Mineski dito. Talaga sobrang aggressive. Walang halong kung ano man. So Erica, ayun nga. I will interview you muna. Kasi, nahihiya ako actually. Actually, it's my first time too, you know. Actually, marami na rin ako nakakasamang kaso yung curly. Ouch. Ayun nga, si Eliza. Yan, siya yung lagi ko nakakasama. Eh, if you know her, Eliza Taylor.
Yeah, I saw her once. Like, last time. Like, but also.
Ayan. Nahihiya ako sa katabi ko. Ayan. Sa mga nanonood, hello. Hello sa inyo. I-greet mo naman yung mga taong nanonood. Diba say hi to
hi.
Them? Hi. Say hi, I'm here, you know. Any shoutouts? Any shoutouts to your friends, families? And she said hi with this, you know, hand gestures and stuff. Okay. Alright, so back to the ball game. 55 seconds left in the clock. Ooh, let's see. Retract trying to give damage to the people of G1. Was Baby Boy kills somebody right here. Retract with a second kill right here. Neruj is right there also. Retract with a headshot and double headshot killing Neruj. But there's someone with Zach killing Retract right there. Zach is the only man left for G1 Wolf. Let's see what will happen. 1v4 situation. The bomb has been planted by Mineski. Alright, so grabe. So Erica, sa tingin mo, kunwari ikaw na lang. Sa 1v4 situation, ano yung sa tingin mo, ano yung pinakamagandang gawin? Sa kunwari, sa perspective mo,
yeah.
Ano yung ginagawa mo sa 1v4 na ikaw na lang yung mag-isa?
Try to get a kill.
Yes, that's the very best thing na magawa mo. Try to get a kill. Just wait for the right moment para makapatay pa ng isa. Just use your strategy. Use your spider sense. Just use everything na inside you na para ma-feel kung ano pa yung mga pwedeng mangyari sa mapa. This is so wrong. Alright, Neruj killing Retrack right there. 4v5 situation, 1 minute 35 seconds left in the call. Let's see what will happen the next few seconds off the game. Neruj, 74 HP sa kanya, and Dispenser, nag-aantay lang talaga. And as you can see, nakikita nyo po yung mga tao dito, talagang nag-iingay lang talaga na pinapakita nila, na I mean, pinaparamdam nila sa G1 Wolves na andun yung Mineski. Alright, so where is Asura when I need you? Alright. I don't know what I'm saying right now. Okay, 1 minute left in the clock. Let's see, 4v5 still. God. Alright, nice smoke there by G1, just blocking the view off Mineski just to fend off, to delay the pushes off Mineski right now. Alright, so 40 seconds left in the clock. Still passive. Wala pa rin nangyayari. Is this your first time casting?
Yes.
Marami pa. Marami pa actually. Pero, kunyari, what's your favorite gun in CSGO?
MP7.
Oh, MP7?
Yeah.
SMG?
Yeah.
Do you like rifles like M4, AK?
It's okay. I mean, I practice AK. Just, you know, so I can...
You're a happy person. I couldn't tell. Yes, because you're all laughing. So. Alright, and back to the ball game. Let's see 3 versus 3 situation. The clock is ticking for Mineski right now. Death finding someone to kill. And what will happen? Oh, Death sees one already. Dubstep trying to stay alive. Let's see. But Death killing Hannibal, the El Capitan of Mineski. 0-2 kills 1 already. And that's the defuse coming from G1 Wolves. Baby Boy is dead. 3-0 now is the score in favor of Mineski. Alright, so later, andito na si Asirai to join us. Once again, thank you very much, Erica, for helping us. Alright, so let's see now. 1 minute 45 seconds left in the clock. 3-1 G1 Wolves. Getting that first point in the game. Grabe.
Alright, so ako pa rin maging mag-transform si Bill, maging Azurai. So ako mas nakaya naman dyan, Erica. How was your first casting experience?
Can't say anything.
It's alright. Well, na natin na mas mataas ang rank mo kaysa sa akin. Teach me how! Or, nakikita mo paano yung mindset dito na ano? Hindi ba? Okay, so never mind. Let's check out how, well, Mineski are approaching this one. It's a 1v1 situation. 100 left into the clock, and you can see here the trigger. Pushing himself up onto heaven, flashes over, so he's trying to fake out here that he's gonna maybe push out from there. Bomb not yet planted, but 50 seconds, lots of time here for Dubstep to just fake it out. Oh, but the peak time! This could be huge. Dubstep, where is he looking at? He's gonna be planting the bomb. I think triggers now. Hearing this, there's the plant. Dubstep, oh, he's peeking, but no! Trigger! The timing couldn't have been so perfect.
Wow.
And that will be the clutch for G1 Wolves. So 2-3 here, guys. Again, yeah, you do have to note that the kabala dyan, eh? Give a little bit of a shout out here to our resident Mineski.man writer.
Nomad.
All right, so it's 2-3, still in favor of Mineski, and G1 is slowly catching up. Recently, Mineski has been practicing overpass quite some time now, and G1 Wolves, this is one of their best maps, so what do you think is going to happen in the second game?
Like I said, I predicted a while ago, it's going to be 2-1, and that one that I gave to Wolves will be for overpass.
Right, but hold that thought, though. Dispenser actually takes down 0-2 there up in middle, and Jaeger is slowly going too long, but no, Dispenser was actually able to pick someone out, and the bomb is now pushing to A long right now. And things are starting to get hairy for G1 here. Only 3 people versus 5 people, but oh wait! Naruge actually takes down Dispenser, and Baby Boy takes down Naruge.
Naruge a bit too trigger happy there, spotting out the one and goes in for the kill. Well, it was good for the one frag, but at the same time, it could have maybe stopped a little bit. They could have lined up for him. He might have actually have gotten like a 2k, even possibly a 3k, but that's not going to be the case here. Now G1 Wolves is going to try to exit away as far away as possible from Mineski. Don't want to lose any of their weapons as they are just going to be reset here coming into round number 7.
Yeah, and they will have the full blue shell effect, right?
Yeah, they won't.
They won't have the blue shell effect, so every single weapon that they have and the smoke that they have there
it's going to be very
count.
Vital.
It's very, very vital. And yeah, the rest of the Mineski squad is trying to go for some wolf hunting. And yeah, they will be living. And right now, I'm going to pass the mic over back to Erica.
It's all right, guys. Guest caster, you know, just sabi mo lang yung naisip mo na nangyayari sa laban na to. Taglish tayo kung gusto mo. Even, you can go a little bit Japanese pero hindi kita maintindihan, so you have to explain every word that you say. Yun na lang. So, can you translate Counter-Strike Global Offensive into Japanese? Can you do that? Alright, so do you see that the trigger as well as 02 recently pushing out onto water, but you can see here, not very back onto sight ni Retrack here. He knows that there's something that might be up for G1 Wolves, and while he's waiting for them to actually push up, the timing, there's plenty of time for him to, you know, rotate back to the embracing hands, arms of his team, but now he's just going to be the lurker here. Did Trigger actually hear him jump up and down outside? I don't know. Not really sure. I think Trigger did know. So now, Zach throwing out the nade. It won't dunk the lead onto anybody. Yep. And, he spots it out, but Dispenser fast on the trigger, gets the kill, and that is already two frags. Make that three already in the hands of Mineski. Now, Zach, he is going to be the lone wolf defending bombs at A, but this wall of smoke, can he sniff him out through the smoke? I mean, does he have the animal instincts to actually hit Hannibal as he does put down the bomb plant? I think that's going to be a no. So maybe Zach here just goes in for the save once more, but Dispenser is there! Easy peasy shot. And Neruj coming in from the backside, but I don't think he's going to make any much impact with the 5-7 against a full-fledged team here of Mineski. Not even one has been dropped down. Alright, so medyo may pagka... shy lang dito si Neruj, but then Retract. They missed each other by a couple of seconds and a couple of meters from the looks of it. That could have been Neruj maybe stealing an AK, but well, that's the case. So, ikaw, Ara, because we're gonna use your IGN. What's your favorite map in CS:GO?
Cash.
Alright, so, this is not cash, I'm just gonna ask something else. Do you play Overpass regularly?
Not so much. It's really hard.
Okay. Also, gonna ask a couple of questions. Maybe you can give your... Oops. Nakapo! My bad, guys. But then, maybe you can give a bit of your insight. What is, like, the best spots here for, you know, to check out on Overpass? But before that, you can see here that there was a stack there from G1. It was my bad, guys. They did get the kill onto Dispenser and Hannibal, and they did drop the bomb. But still, no weapons was picked up by G1 Wolves. Now, Baby Boy going to be able to pick this one up. He's going to try to exit out. Well, he's going to push himself up on Party, but doesn't spot anyone right here on Battle's Bay. Oh, that thought! Nice crossfire there by G1 Wolves, and only Dubstep remains. That's the one frag onto Zach. That's a good opener here, but it's a 3v1 situation. He has to manually check every single corner that he has to be able to retrieve the C4. He thinks that someone's defending it, but nobody will, so he'll be able to get this one back up. But again, this is nice 180 rotate there, but he couldn't get the kill onto Death. So Death knowing now where Dubstep is. Dubstep throwing out an AK. He's trying to hide them as much as possible. He's good headshot there. 2v1 situation. Zero, though, does have an AK, but he's all the way down on connector. And Dubstep has a real chance of actually clutching this in a 2v1. Dubstep? 10 seconds. Will he actually plant, or will he just fake it and try to get the kills? Oh, he loses the bullets. Tries to go in quite a bit more. Dubstep doesn't have enough time. He tries to go for the spray. Not gonna happen. Nice coordination there from G1 Wolves. Okay, so gonna ask you the question here. On the CT side or on the T side, whichever you pick, what is like the vital points that you have to look at here on Overpass? You can point it out and I'll just, you know, draw it.
I don't know. When I'm city, I usually go B. I'm a B player.
Alright. So B.
Yeah. And I just hide on waters. That's it.
Then you win.
Sometimes. It depends if they rush.
Alright. Maybe just other questions. For that though, gonna be a push here from Mineski's side. Make that into 3v3. And They are still outside of the site here, but Dubstep has to work to get back to C4. He's very far! Very actually... Well, I thought very near though, but could not get the no-scope to his opponent. Retrack, he's a loyal onto bombs at A. This is a 3v1 here, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, wait, what happened? Oh yeah, never mind. Retrack was actually on water. This was Trigger's perspective. My mistake. Retrack though, pushing up from Monster, but again, this is a 3v1. Same with what Dubstep had a while ago? Or was that the Spencer thing? No, that was Babe. That Dubstep. But now, he has to peek all the way in, but you can see here he's crouching, giving as much info as he can. He gets one tap, yes he does, but he spots Choco's in for Toxic. Zach, he is at the back of tank. Spots out Trigger, he's getting a headshot, this could be huge. Retrack, two more kills, one left, only Zach remains. This is gonna be huge, he gets it. Oh, the clutch from Retrack, that was enormous.
That was so good.
Definitely a good play. Have a Retrack. The, how do you call it? What's the title of Retrack, old man? Hindi, kasi si Clive yun eh. Old man si Arvis at si Clive. Sino si, paano, ano yung title ni Retrack? The, old man din. Oh, di wala din. Ayan, we'll just keep it for first old man. Maybe you guys there in the chat can help us out if you're much more, well, inclined with retracking and give us like a good title to dub him as. Okay, so what was the question I was gonna ask? Oh, there you go. How long have you been playing CSGO?
CSGO, a year almost.
CS.
CS, I tried it when I was in elementary. I played with my friends.
Okay. How did you get so good? Because I've played with you a couple of times and like
good.
you're really well practiced with the AK. I mean, better than I am for sure.
No.
Better than Nomad for sure. Yeah, he can't say no to that because oh, Trigger here though. Okay, that was a standard position. So Baby Boy though, nice aim though. Gets a headshot, and now they do get full control of bombsite A. All the other members of G1 Wolves who are still alive are actually here pushing up to connector, but Retrack, oh, he's waiting sneaky beaky like right onto connector, grinding him up. The one frag, no! He gets taken down though. Zach tagged 218, and they'll be able to save up an AK-47. The dispenser is hunting down Zach. He doesn't want any scrap items to be given to G1 Wolves for sure here. Oh, they're hunting him. The wolf hunts its prey. Zach, strike wrap around, but the barrel of his gun was caught. Now, checking out the economy here. Checking out the economy here for G1 Wolves, they're very much in tatters. Like they're buying up, but then like it's only two rifles and pistols. Oh, there we go. Zero within an AWP. No AWP here though for Mineski, but they don't really have to. Like they're Dubson hasn't shown to be the most effective AWP player here, so I guess like having him on an AK would be better. You know, just because like if you get one shot off and you miss it with the AWP, you're like a little bit vulnerable for maybe one and a half seconds. So having the AK, just hope going for the sprays, this would be the decision here for Mineski. Or you know, they don't have any money. No, they have like a ton, so never mind. Retrack again, the lurker here for Mineski. He's outside on sandbags, but nothing yet has. He's not doing anything just yet. The timing on Zach there though could have been way off. Good shot from 0-2. And I thought that was actually 0-2 getting the kill, but Trigger does have it. FAMAS in hand. Though you can see that hot on his track was supposed to be Dispenser, but Dispenser rotating back. Though Death was able to stop the push by Baby Boy. He's right onto the pillar here. And right outside Monster as well, he's trying to slow peek. Does he have a flash to actually aggress himself in? I don't think that's going to be the case. But Dispenser, does he actually peek to the left side? Yes, he does, but Death, ooh, the positioning. angles. Dispenser. Wow. The mindset from him, that was... Now, in a 2v2 situation though, you don't peek zero from up on heaven. He will just put you straight back into hell. And that was a good shot from him. Now, only the captain of Mineski survives. Hannibal starts it off strong with a headshot onto Trigger. Oh, the captain's actually... Oh, he knows where he's at. Oi! Andale, andale, arriba! He's gonna flash himself out. Doesn't flash 0-2, but 0! Oh no! And that... Oh, does he have enough time? I don't know. It's gonna be close. Oh, it's gonna be close! Counter-terrorists win. Man, fraction of a second there. That was something. So what do you think about that game?
That was really good.
Yeah. Sige, okay lang yun. Okay lang yun. Like, definitely good. What part did you like about that the most? Sneaky. Kasi yan eh. Like, sleep press yung nag-iisip para sa team sila ngayon. Kailangan nila mag-iisip para sa sarili nila. Looks like Shane got the better of that one. Or, sorry, 0-2 got the better of that one. And look at this. The boost. 2-0-2. Doesn't even need to do that. He backs down as he thought that Mineski might have been pushing outside from water. Throws out the nade. Eats it a little bit. Re-track gets spotted out. 0-2. So damn on point. Right there. And now, 4v3 with Mineski. A little bit out. Like, they're really far away from each other. Dubstep looking from outside of Monster with an AWP. He's going to peek and spot out Zach. That could be good here to make that into a 3v3. Gonna flash himself over. Maybe force out a peek from 0-2 and catch off the opposing AWPer. But that doesn't happen just yet. Baby Boy pushing up onto the side here. Goes for a very wild one tap, hoping to get a shot off. And he does get the one. He's going for the second one. He's gonna peek onto Bank with a knife. And no, cannot do so. But Hannibal right onto outside. He's jumping up and down. Gets spotted out by Zach. Zach takes his head off. And it's a very close match. 5-7. And here's the start of G1 Wolves racking up a lot of economy. Alright, so... Okay. Aside from that, let's just... if you guys want to know more, I guess, about Erica Okumura, also known as Ara, you can check out her article, her Nomads article at Mineski.net for the WASD Grill, CSGO Grills. Is that the title? CSGO Grills? Grill Power. Grill Power. George! Tactical Timeout Special. Okay. George Foreman Grill. Now I want some meat. I'm hungry. No, because grills, man. What do grills do? They cook your meat. No! What the hell, dude? Like, literally. Double spray, though, from Trigger, but that was a fast take by Mineski. Who's going to be on the side defending? It's going to be Zero. Close over the second, but Buddy Boy. Very fast for that one, Nerouge. Here to pick up some slack, and it's only in the hands of Dispenser without armor that he has to go up against for a two M4 A1Ss, as well as the one FAMAS in the hand of Death. Oh my god, I think the other Nomad, like, odd-shotting that one. Oh, jeez. But, aside from that fiasco that I just said, G1 Wolves definitely coming back from this one. Look at that, 6-17, and the road to 1-1 is looking very bright here for G1 Wolves as they are catching up against Mineski. Now, oh, she predicted that. Okay. It's fine. It's just a simple question. A quick question with a simple answer. Why did you pick G1 Wolves to win this one?
Did they choose this map?
Yes, they did.
So, ah, that means they're good with it, I guess.
Okay. So Trigger here actually just positioning himself up, throws out a Molotov, and the rest of Mineski's squad setting up for an A. Trigger with a pretty good position on cross. 0-2 gets spotted out. Gets back into the safety of the smoke. Gonna throw out a wild nade. Will it dunk? No, it's not. Molotov though. Hannibal actually planting in the front of Trigger. Just not get spotted out. And Hannibal, does he survive? No. The dispenser left in a 4v1 situation. Gonna go for the double spray. Cannot do so. And that is G1 Wolves coming back with a 7-7 right now, ladies and gentlemen. On to the last round of the first half. Does Mineski have money to buy with? Can they do so? They only have like 4,000 max, so they will be able to. Terracite is very cheap, and now Ara has become a man.
Hello. Wow, 7-7 from 5-2.
You came at the very awkward time.
Yes.
Nakabala kang G1 Wolves with like a 7-7.
Alright, siguro pag ako hindi kaka, siguro ano.
Wala na lang yung Mineski.
Yes,
you're jinxing
G1
Wolves, yeah. Oh!
I am tired.
0-2! What could this be? Oh! The aggression! The pure confidence of 0-2 takes down Hannibal.
So let's see now, G1 Wolves at 7 points, wow, from 5-2. Comeback is real. Alright, so anyway, 1 minute 15 seconds left in the clock. 0-2 with 46 HP and with his favorite gun, the up. Let's see what will Mineski do to win this game and to break the streak or the momentum of G1 Wolves. So 0-2 killed 2 already, but Dispenser from the sides killing 0-2. Alright, so wow, Trigger killing Dispenser and Death Trigger. Dubs up as well, 1v4 situation. What will happen? Retract from the sides killing Naruch right there, going in for the second, but Blasty's right there behind that crate, and that's it. The first half of the game, G1 Wolves, wow, giving that 8-7, that 1 point deficit is really vital for G1 Wolves right now.
Yeah, now though, Mineski will be playing on the defensive team. Is G1 Wolves gonna go for a raid boss yet again? I don't think they're gonna. Are they gonna push it for that one though? That's the, oh yeah, I think they are yet again.
Alright, so can you please enlighten me on what happened the last five rounds? I don't know, man.
I have to give it to 0-2 for getting so many op kills in the first half.
From 5-2, dude.
To 8-7. And now they actually have a 1-round lead against
Mineski. Alright, so let's see now. Zach getting tagged right there, 6-8 HP left. So
who's on the side defending? Nobody is.
Yeah, I don't know. Dude, there's only one man defending B-side. Hannibal killed one already. Let's see a double kill coming from Hannibal. And coming in for the triple. Let's just wait for the right moment. Let's see if he can kill one more. Hannibal, still 100 HP with a double kill in his pocket. 1 minute left and the bomb has been planted by G1 Wolves. Baby Boy trying to go to the backstab. That's good, but Baby Boy kills one already. Hannibal and Dubstep is right there. 0-2 is the only man left. 1v5 situation. Let's see what will happen. And I think Mineski will get this round 8-8.
He tried to force himself in and gets stopped in his tracks by Mineski.
Yes, indeed.
Now, yeah, this is 8-8, but G1 Wolves, are they going to go for the force buy? Or, again, will they just hold on to their money and buy up onto the next round? The safer choice, I think, giving Mineski at least one round, it wouldn't hurt too much if they can buy up on the next round with AKs and utility all across the board. So that's going to be the choice here for G1 Wolves, but the freight train, the Glock train is nigh. Look at that line.
Alright, so let's see the train to A-side.
The train to Busan. The beast, Busan.
The train to A-side, everyone.
Busan.
The train to Busan. Here we go, Death leading away. Let's see, Death. And he stopped for some unknown reason. And now Dubstep is right there just defending together with Dispenser. Let's see what will happen. Dubstep is right there. Dispenser right there. The triple kill. The double kill. The Dubstep and Dispenser. And the triple dips Dubstep. Dude. The train to Busan
and
is
got
already destroyed.
And they got wiped out in the blink of an eye.
3 for Dubstep, 2 for Dispenser, 5 to none. And a big thanks to Erica for helping us cast here. We really thanks for that grill, Wasty Grill. And a big shout out to the love of my life who's here.
Yes, the goddess of wisdom.
The goddess of wisdom, Athena. And I'm the god of...
I don't want to say it.
Yes, please don't. Yes, I have my dignity. Please don't destroy it.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, you know me, you know me. I am pure. I am innocent. I am a virgin. Okay. Sorry? Bible study, all right. I do Bible studies every Saturday and Thursdays, and I have charity work every week.
Yeah.
Yes. I am that pure. Thank you very much. And okay, back to the ball game. 1 minute, 10 seconds left in the clock. Still 5 versus 5. No aggressions, no passive. I mean, everything. Everyone just doing their passive strategies right there.
Now... Oh, Hannibal actually pushing up onto A-Long and then just backs off here onto bathrooms. Does he hear that there's the push from G1 Wolves? I don't think that he did. And G1 Wolves, the timing couldn't have been better for them. I think Hannibal doesn't know that they are on A-Long, but he's going to peek it nonetheless. Is this going to reposition? Oh no, he's going to go into B. They're thinking that they might actually go to B. The mind games here for G1 Wolves.
Alright, so let's see now dubstep. Maybe they're going to B side. They're staying at the connector side.
There's a flash.
Call from Dubstep now. Death knows that there's someone right there. And there's a Molotov coming from Dubstep also. Same Death. But Dispenser with a follow-up kill. Killing Death. 4 versus 4 situation right here. What will happen? 15 seconds left. And I think they're going to go to the B side. Let's see. But Baby Boy is right there. One kill coming from Baby Boy. And they go with the second kill. But Yuru just destroying Baby Boy right here. 2 versus 3 situation. And the Bubble Jump also. Retract. Is down the Rouge killing 1 versus 2 and the Rouge is down. Hannibal the El Capitan just destroying the Rouge again.
Baby Boy definitely the linchpin for that round there. I mean, he just sticked here at the very back of sight, sat there for the longest time. And when they started planting, when he saw that, like it was, like he said, he knew that his opponent was like, oh no, why are you there, Baby Boy? Gets the one repositions. Yes. And then they takes two before going down. So nicely timed there by Baby Boy.
The old man with the baby face.
That's what he calls him, saying Baby Boy. Isn't that... Then shouldn't he be called Baby Man?
I don't know.
Yeah,
he likes to be called Baby Boy. I don't know.
Baby Man.
Yeah, what a Baby Man. Meanwhile, Naruj, the Baymax. Oh my god. Reverse for the Hannibal getting tag right here. T-Track kills one already. Dubstep kills one as well with the HE grenade. Two versus three. Naruj is down. A very clean route. Clean sweep there by Mineski. The score now is 11-8. Will G1 Wolves push everything to a 1-1?
That's Ara is nodding her head and yes, like, sabi, puso lang yan.
Yes, puso. What is puso in Japanese? Puso na. Puso.
What now?
Sorry?
Kokoro.
Kokoro.
Oh, right. Right in the kokoro.
What?
Right in the kokoro.
Kokoro. Let's... Hayaku is faster. Alright. I like... Hayaku.
Hayaku.
Hayaku. Hayaku!
Wait. Oh, it holds for that one though before we do all some right. More interrogation here. It's gonna be the push.
It's a very Hayaku movement.
Oh, sneaky Beagle Light comes from the back line. It's going to be Dubstep here waiting for them, but it's gonna be the. Maybe it's gonna be the commitment here for G1
Wolves. Oh! He heard the op sound. The op shot, rather. No, Hannibal. Wow, get a full bait and a kill there by 0-2, killing Hannibal. 4 versus 3 situation. 1 minute left in the clock. Retract. Trying to be sneaky behind the smoke, but Death is killing him. Just anticipating there's someone right there behind the smoke right now. 2 versus 3 situation. 0-2 is dead. Dubstep there. Kills one already in the route. The Baymax kills one as well. The Dispenser goes down. 9-11 is the score. Hello, US.
But then Mineski do have money to buy 9-11 back up again.
Don't forget. What?
Nothing, man.
Alright.
Again, Mineski to back it up with the money that they got for 4 straight rounds that they won on the second half. Yes. So they'll be able to buy up. I guess after this one, if they do lose, they'll be reset. But at the same time, if they win this one, they will, or rather, they'll be challenged in the economy. Then, if they do with this one, it'll be Geo and Wolves reset in terms of like how much money they can have, and that's gonna give like at least one or two rounds in the hands of Mineski.
Mm-hmm. All right, now, so let's see. 1 minute 20 seconds left in the clock. Mineski with the upper hand with the 2 points.
Look at this one, Mineski definitely just giving control of bathrooms and A long.
Yes.
So you don't want to give that,
you know,
much
with Hannibal on the backs. Yeah. As well.
Don't really want to give that much control there. Plus, I.
Ooh, wow, zero Q killing Hannibal.
They don't learn. They don't learn. You don't.
Dude.
Jump on.
You should learn from your mistakes.
Yeah, they've done it like thrice already, and yeah, they keep getting caught by 0-2 there. But now there is some sort of rotation here from Geon Wolves. They're not fully committing onto bomb side A, but Mineski are also at the same
right
time trying to wrap around, getting as many information as possible. But they are
Let's
thinned
see,
out
baby
here.
Boy is a very. It's a very perfect position. Just waiting for the right moment again to kill someone. 35 seconds left in the clock. G1 Wolf is nowhere to be found. He doesn't know where.
I don't really like this from
Mineski.
Like Mineski are like forming them, are getting these awkward, but then could
but
be
baby
high
boy,
impact.
Wait, baby yeah. boy, baby boy.
Could be high impact plays, but then high impact play spots, but then at the same time.
Ooh, Dubstep there with the double can going in for the triple. Let's see, but 0-2, killing Dubstep right there, 1 versus 3 situation. 10 seconds left in the clock.
And now, there's only a 3v1. GR, he's just gonna save a weapon. That's the AWP, so he's gonna give...
Nice move. Yes. Nice flash.
I have to talk about this again. Like, I didn't like the position too much of Mineski there. Just because, like, they were going for, like, these wraparounds.
Oh. Alright.
They were going for, like, these wraparound plays, or, maneuvers, but then at the same time, if they get kicked off, they kind of like break down this thin wall of defense that they have, and that's mm-hmm. gonna give us such
yes,
a big
indeed.
Opening for G1 Wolves. Though G1 Wolves did not see this, they couldn't exploit it that much, and what should have been a downfall of Mineski kind of like got a pros out of it, that if G1 Wolves kind of pushed up and did not check out these off angles where Mineski were positioning themselves, they could actually just swarm from all angles, and that's what Mineski did. Now Dubstep looking. But does he have the AWP? Nope. He's gonna get a one shot, but then M4A1S against the Tech-9, I believe. Yeah, probably. Oh! Dispenser! Gonna get one shot before he goes down! No!
Wow.
That's not gonna be the case there. But it's gonna be, look at it, it's Mineski just
four
backing
versus
up onto
four
the side.
Now.
4 versus 4 indeed. And GR, or sorry, Zero looking at.
I'm gonna call him
Sandbags.
Blasty. Blasty is easier
yeah.
than GR. Right.
Trigger.
Trigger. Blasty. You don't have a choice. 1 minute left in the clock, and as you can see, the wall of Mineski is now formed.
Like
the line. Yes.
I mean, even if they are a bit thinned out, they have so much cover to work with here.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's see. The train to Busan is waiting to be launched.
Mineski's not going to fall for that one again.
Leading the way. Should learn from your mistakes.
But then... It has its own pros and cons. Like, jumping up and down from that gives you a lot of information. Oh, retract, very much on point. Goes for the second.
Nice kill by the retract.
Not gonna happen though. But he has made the impact already here. Dubstep.
Two versus
spot
three
out
now. Death is right there. 0-2 is the only man left. But where is 0-2?
0-2 right outside of bathrooms.
Yes, alright. This is a very tight situation for 0-2 right now.
Will
nice.
He get the Mineski flush? Or
but there's someone right there. Ooh, I think he kills one, but Baby Boy's right there behind him. It's 13-9.
He tried to go for the 180, but yeah. could not execute it.
Yes. Mineski going strong, but at least G1 Wolves forced everyone to force everything to 9 points.
Yeah, but Mineski do survive with 2 members, so they were able to get quite a bit of weapons back, and then of course they
nice knife, bro.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about a while ago. Berger is a very expensive knife because it's sapphire.
Yes.
And the purity of it is...
Do you have an idea of how much?
Not really sure. Wait, this is... what knife was that again? Not really 100% sure on the name of it. I only have like... I'm a poor man. I only have a hunter's knife.
Dude, I have a default knife. Alright, so death. Turn one already. Trying to go for the second, but... Wow, GR there with a double kill. 2v3 situation. Let's see what will happen the next few seconds of the game right now. Retrack and Dubstep is the only man left, but where are they?
Where are they?
Hola!
It's Batman. It's Batman, dude. Where are they? Dubstep from above. Justice reigns
from above
with the Tech Nines.
Yes.
Now in a 2v2, Death only has a B250, but he's wrapping around. Can they hear him?
Let's see. From the side. Die there.
And Dubstep with the Tech Nine. Just
killing him. Yes, exactly. And the score is 14-9 above the snack bar.
And with this, it's 9-14. Mineski up almost onto match point. Two more rounds, and they will get this away from the hands of G1 Wolves to go up into the semis bracket.
All right, so can you please pause? I think the match is not in progress. Arvin, where are you when we need you? Paging. All right, so.
Yeah, he's here. nades are disabled. 14-9, we're gonna just reload this one, guys. So hold on to your seats. Sorry for the delay, but. Again, if you're watching
all right,
now,
so hello.
Yeah, this is the Mineski Pro. Wait, can you see that?
Yes, CSGO. I need to show my Twitch jacket first. Rate.
All right, so again, you're watching the Mineski Pro Gaming League Season 8 Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
Rise from the rest.
We're right now on our second leg, and your turn.
All right, so back to the ball game. It's on now.
All right. So before that, we would like to thank our official sponsors, GGRT TV, Twitch, Gigabyte, ViewSonic, Mineski Infinity, Cyber Cafe, and Nationwide, Secret Shop, where you can buy
secret things.
And of course, special thanks to Weir Force 2016 LAN Tournament.
Hashtag Road to Taiwan. See you there.
And Dubstep actually. Yeah, there you go.
All right, so as you can see, Zero just killing Dubstep again. And, oh.
Wow.
Alright, so meanwhile, I would like to greet the viewers who are watching this game, the thousands of viewers out there. Thank you for watching. And of course, I would like to greet everyone who's inside the studio. I'm about to greet Arvin, Jiro, Lan, Darwell, Carl, and Lucky. And of course, our special guest, Erica. And of course, my the love of my life, save the best for last.
The goddess of wisdom.
It's the goddess of wisdom. Thank you very much.
So our scoreline here, guys, is 14-9. Don't be fooled by the 0-0. That's not the real score, boys.
Yes, it's not 0-0. So meanwhile, I would like to point. All right.
All right, there we go.
So
it's
back.
Yeah,
it's back. It's back. Spice back.
Oh wow! I forgot that name already.
Yeah, me too. Actually, Spice back messaged me yesterday. He just said hi.
I see. I still get the messages from one of the players there. Oh, if you guys did not know, it's fine to talk about this. We also casted
Halo
5.
Yes, Halo 5, the World Championships.
Not World Championships,
Asia Regional finals in Kwantung.
Yeah, shoutouts to the Philippine team as well as the team of Mobius Infinity, now known as Skyfire.
Skyfire from Singapore.
Skyfire is actually a huge team in Southeast Asia.
Indeed, yes.
In FPS.
Right, so back to the ball game. 14-9. Wow, Naruj killed one. And, dude, G1 Wolves is on fire.
But Dubstep has made some crazy plays with the Tech Nine, and it looks like he might do so yet again, though in a 3v1. It sounds like thunder rumbling.
Yes, exactly. Dude, Valve, why?
No, actually, I prefer this one because the...
It's more terrifying.
Not because of that. The sounds itself, it's very recognizable as AWP, but at the same time, it doesn't hurt my ears when I fire an AWP.
Yeah, it's more realistic, actually.
Realistic, and again, it doesn't hurt your ears because the one before was a bit too sharp that my eardrums kind of felt like they were bleeding every time I shot an AWP when I was on high volume.
Why would you even play CSGO in high volume?
Because CSGO's a game of sounds. It's a game of sounds, man.
Yeah, I know.
Exactly.
I'd rather go with the, it's like... You can compare the sound of an AWP to a scout. It's just the same, maybe. I don't know.
What is the weapon of Dubstep? Is that a Hyper Beast?
He is rich
it
as
looks, it
father.
Looks like a black Hyper Beast.
Black.
Yeah, there, see? Oh no, never mind. It's just being in the dark. Can't see it properly. Oh, Hannibal there though. Almost gets the 1K. But here, right now...
I know someone who is darker and...
Only Dubstep remains with a legit primary weapon. Recheck, of course, has a P250. He can make impact plays with this one. But he has to be on close range or, you know, just be very, very lucky that his gun will, like, dink someone from far away range or even at mid range.
All right, so 4 versus 2. I don't know what is happening to Mr. right now. Maybe on the tilt, but, you know, the power of G1 Wolves is here. Who picked
Overpass? G1 Wolves.
All right.
So is this going to be 1-1 pushing up onto train?
Mineski picked G1 Wolves.
Yeah, G1.
All these people. I don't know. All right, so still 2 versus 4. We track and Dubstep just crawling.
They're trying to save their weapons.
Yes, indeed. All right, so we track, trying to play some swings and stuff. Playground 0-2. They can hear the footsteps. Misses the first shot. Nice kill there by Retrack. Kills 1. 3 versus 2 situation. The clock is ticking. Ooh, Naruj destroying Retrack right there. James Carter, Retrack, Aang. LeBron James, Vince Carter, and
Avatar Aang.
Avatar Aang. I like his name. It's like really planned for that stuff.
Retrack. James Carter Aang.
Is it A-A-N-G or A-N-G for Carter?
I think it's
A-N-G.
A-N-G.
If it's A-A-N-G.
Oh, Dubstep misses the shot. That could have been good.
Yes.
Good start off there for Mineski, but couldn't follow through.
It's fine. Alright, so 11-14 now. G1 Wolves.
Yeah. So 14 for Mineski and 11 for the G1 Wolves
yes,
side.
Yes, we're getting some bugs, I'm sorry. And yeah, 14 for Mineski, 11 for G1 Wolves.
They can't see that. Because if you guys are checking, maybe, we do have like overlays to cover.
Alright.
Yeah, so you just can't see it.
Okay. Sorry.
Dispenser though.
Now Dispenser with a follow-up kill there by Zach. 4 versus 4 and 1 minute left in the clock. Alright, so let's see if the Great Wall of Mineski is really working to defend this bomb site right now.
Mineski, I think like right now, are feeling exhaustion. Because yesterday they also played a match against China.
Yes, EMC, right?
EMC, right?
EMC.
And what I heard was that it was 13-2, and they got it back to 15-15, and then they were also able to get it to overtime. They kind of lost the first overtime. It was pushed to second overtime, and that's when they lost. So right now, like they're still, you know, playing really well, but at the same time, the pressure already, the exhaustion could be reaching them, and maybe Wolves are thriving in this one.
They can use that as their practice, though. Ooh.
Fight the power of
Papa Pow.
Of stress. Now zero.
So
in a
zero
4v1.
T. I mean two. They
oh,
said T.
Wow. You almost get spotted there. Match point.
Match point there for Mineski right now. Finally.
So here it is. Make or break it. For G1 Wolves, can they go for the straight 4 rounds and push this to overtime, or will Mineski rise from the rest and win against G1 here? Mm-hmm. I don't know what's happening right now. to my co-casters right here.
Alright, so 0-2, 6-2 HP left. Nice flambe there by Mineski. Alright, so that Dubstep trying to be sneaky behind that smoke. Ooh.
It kind of goes without saying that if you're an AWP player, you always have like a 5-7 P250 or a Tech 9 in hand.
Mm-hmm, yes, indeed. Oh, meanwhile, Hannibal with a double kill. 2 versus 4 situation. 4 DG. The Rouge goes down. 4 DG is only my left. 4 G1 Wolves, what will happen? He got the Molly. He got tagged as well. Let's see.
He got tagged by one. That's a lot of damage.
Yes, of course. And let's see now. And that's it. GG. Well played.
And your winners for this best of two series,
Caster Cam,
G1 Wolves versus Mineski CSGO. Your winner.